Let us now take the next set of questions from this topic of mensuration, where we have to indirectly use either the formula of perimeter or the area of a two-dimensional shape to get the required answer. Let's look at the first example. A fence is to be drawn around a circular ground of radius 7 meters. What will be the total expenditure if the cost of fencing is rupees 120 per meter? So here we are supposed to find out the total expenditure if the cost of fencing is rupees 120 per meter. So as given in the question, there is a circular ground. Let's take this as a circular ground. Radius is 7 meters. And fence is to be drawn around the circular ground. That means fence has to be put across this circular ground. Now as you can see, when we put a fence around a circular ground or any two-dimensional shape for that matter, we are actually working on the perimeter. That means here, first of all, to find out the total cost, we need to know what is the length of the boundary. Why? Because a fence is nothing but the boundary. We are working on the boundary. So until and unless we know the length of the boundary, we cannot go ahead for calculating the total expenditure. So first of all, let us find out what is the length of the boundary. And we know that length of the boundary is nothing but the perimeter. And perimeter or circumference for a circle is given as 2 pi r, where pi is the constant given by 22 by 7 and r is the radius. Now as given in the question, radius is 7 meters. So let us substitute here and find out the perimeter. So this can be taken as 2 into 22 by 7 into radius is given as 7 meters. So this 7 and 7 gets cancelled and the perimeter comes out to be 2 into 22, that is 44 meters. Remember friends, perimeter is a measurement of length and length should be taken always in terms of meters or centimeters as the case may be. Now since the radius is in meters, perimeter will be also in meters. So the total perimeter or the length of the boundary here is 44 meters. And the question says, what is the total expenditure if the cost of fencing is 120 per meter? So for one meter length, the cost is rupees 120. So what will be the total cost is the question. So total cost will be nothing but perimeter into the cost per meter. So we can say that total expenditure will be equal to the perimeter into cost per meter or per meter cost. So this can be taken as 44, that is the perimeter, into cost per meter is 120. So this comes out to be 5280 rupees. So we can say that the total expenditure is 5280 rupees. So this is how, by using the formula for perimeter or circumference of a circle, we can find out the answer for the given question. Likewise, instead of a circular field, there can be a rectangular field or a square field or any type of two-dimensional shape. We need to find out the perimeter and then multiply with per meter cost to get the total cost of fencing. And the other point that we need to understand here is, it need not be fencing always. It can be any other activity where we are working on the boundary. For example, let's say a person has to construct a compound wall along the boundary of his premises. So construction of compound wall is again on the perimeter. So if the cost of construction per meter is given, then we can find out the total cost. Let us now take the second example from model 2 of mensuration. The floor of a rectangular auditorium of length 40 feet and breadth 28 feet is to be covered with a wall-to-wall carpet. Find the total cost if the carpet costs rupees 72 per square feet and the pasting charges is rupees 6 per square feet. So as you can see here, there is a rectangular auditorium as shown in the figure. Length is 40 and the breadth is 28 as given in the question. 40 feet and 28 feet. Now the floor of this rectangular auditorium has to be covered with a wall-to-wall carpet. That means nothing but we are placing a carpet on the rectangular floor. The carpet costs rupees 72 per square feet and the pasting charges is rupees 6 per square feet. We are supposed to find out the total cost. Now if you observe here, when we put a wall-to-wall carpet, we are actually working on the complete area of the rectangular floor. That is nothing but the area occupied by the rectangular auditorium. Now we know that area of a rectangular auditorium is equal to length into breadth. The length as given in the question is 40 feet and the breadth is 28 feet. So 40 into 28 is 1120. And here the units will be 1120 square feet. Why? Because both length and breadth are in terms of feet. So area will be in terms of 1120, that is 1120 square feet. That means the total area of this auditorium here is equal to 1120. Now we need to put a carpet across this area of 1120 square feet. And the cost of carpet is 72 per square feet, and the pasting charges is rupees 6 per square feet. So what will be the total cost? So as you can see, because we are working on the area of the floor, we first need to find out what is the area, and then that area multiplied by the cost will give us the total cost. Now here the carpet cost per square feet is rupees 72 as given, and the pasting charges, the pasting cost is rupees 6 per square feet. So altogether for 1 square feet the cost is 72 plus 6, that is 78 per square feet. But we have to work on 1120 square feet. So I can say the total cost here will be equal to 1120 square feet multiplied by cost per feet, that is 78. So when simplified, this comes out to be 87,360 rupees. So we can say that the total expenditure or the total cost of laying a wall-to-wall carpet on this rectangular auditorium will be 87,360 rupees. Similarly, instead of a rectangular auditorium, we can have any other shape. For example, it can be a square hall or it can be a circular auditorium. Whatever be the case, first of all find out the total area, then multiply by the cost per square feet to get the required answer. So that is the difference between example 1 and example 2. In example 1, as you have seen, we were working on the perimeter. So first we find out the perimeter and then find out the total cost. And in example 2 here, we are working on the area. So first we need to find out the area and then multiply with the per square feet cost to get the total cost. One important point that I would like to mention here is, as given in this question, we are laying a wall-to-wall carpet on this rectangular floor. But other than wall-to-wall carpet, there can be many other actions which are done on the floor. For example, the question may talk about floor polishing. There is a rectangular auditorium where floor polishing has to be done, and the cost per square feet is given to us. So even in that case, we can understand that when we polish the floor, we are actually working on the area. Or let's say the total flooring is being done. Tiles are being laid. So cost per square feet is given to us. So again, in this case as well, when we are laying the tiles or when we are doing the flooring of the hall, we are actually working on the complete area. So in all these type of cases, we need to find out the area and then find out the total cost. So we should be properly able to decide that is it the area or the perimeter on which we are working. And then when multiplied by the cost per unit, we can get the required answer.